Hello YouTube, what is up? Today I will show you how to paint leather cloak, fur and base on my Shadespire Orc Captain. I paint all of my Shadespire models to a tabletop quality, so this is a decent looking effect that is quick and easy to replicate on a mass scale. I started with base coating all of the cloak with scale 75 black leather. Scale 75 paints are rather transparent, so I applied 3 or 4 layers to achieve full opacity. I used a hairdryer in between each layer to speed up drying times. When I was happy with the base coat, I started to apply various textures to the cloak. I started with scale 75 red leather as the first layer. I used an old Citadel dry brush and stippled the paint on most of the cloak, leaving the base coat showing only in the deepest recesses. This technique is similar to a regular dry brush. I used undiluted paint straight from the bottle, wiped most of the paint from the brush on a paper towel, and randomly poked the cloak, leaving irregular patterns of color. At the end, I switched to a piece of kitchen sponge and applied some more random textures. The type of application is the same as with the brush, wiping most of the paint away from the sponge. It just leaves a different type of pattern than the brush. The effect is very subtle, but it's a good base to add more textures with brighter colors. Next layer was done with scale 75 brown leather. This time I only used a sponge and focused on a smaller area than before, mostly on the ridges and edges of the cloak. As the final step, using a sponge, I added some more textures using scale 75 orange leather. Next step is to add some final highlights and scratches with scale 75 Iroko. I used a brush this time as I wanted more control than can be achieved with a sponge. I diluted the paint this time and added some dots and lines on the ridges and edges. I also made some random scratches to add some more interest to the cloak. This step takes the most time, but it really makes a difference in the end. When I was happy with the texturing, I used Scale 75 Chestnut Ink diluted with Lamium Medium in about 5:1 ratio. I applied it as a filter all over the cloak in order to tie all of the colors together. Next, I applied Noun Oil diluted 1:1 with Lamium Medium just to the recesses to make them a bit darker. Scale 75 inks are quite glossy, so as the last step I sprayed it with AK Interactive Ultra Matte Varnish to reduce the shine, but this step is optional. This is how the cloak looks after varnishing. I then moved to painting the fur. I base coated it with Scale 75 Petroleum Grey and applied two thin layers for full opacity. After all of the fur was base coated, I glued both pieces together and dry brushed Scale 75 Brown Grey on all of the fur, making sure I do not apply the paint on surrounding areas that were already painted. Second dry brush highlight was done with Scale 75 Rain Grey, this time I focused on the areas that would naturally catch more light. I washed all of the fur areas with undiluted Noun Oil. It darkened the fur a bit too much, so I very gently dry brushed it again with Rain Grey. This is how the finished effect looks like. I removed the miniature from the base and base coated all of the stone areas with Citadel Mechanical Standard Grey. Two layers were needed for full opacity. After the base coat was dry, I washed it twice with 1:1 mix of Noun Oil and Lamium Medium. I masked the orange boots with masking putty and dry brushed Citadel Downstone, followed by a second layer of dry brush with Citadel Tyrant Skull. As the last step, I washed it again with the same mix of Noun Oil and Lamium Medium as before. The skull was painted in a standard Games Workshop way. Xandri Dust base coat, washed with Agrax Earthshade and highlighted with Ushabti Bone. The skull is barely visible when the mini is attached, so I did not feel like it needed any more highlighting. This is how the base looks after all of the areas were painted. As the last step, I added a couple of mini nature summer tufts. I used a thick super glue to attach them to the base. This is how the base looks with tufts applied. I glued the model to the base and painted the rim of the base black. This is how the model looks when it is fully assembled. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. If you did, then like and subscribe if you want to see more. See you next time.